So now we have added some videos to our catalog, so we have something to work with. So let's start to talk a bit about the functionality we have in the software. So first of all, Fast Video Cataloger is composed of a number of windows, and you can control which windows you want to show and which you don't want to show, and you control where you want them to show. Now I'm only recording one computer screen, but it's perfectly possible and also recommended to use more computer screens, since you get more screen estate and then you can set up a dashboard to allow you to work even more efficiently. But even on one screen, the software is optimized to make as good use as possible of the screen estate we have. So first, we have this default layout. We saw the add video window where we added videos. Now the videos are added and we see all the videos in the video catalog view. So the video catalog window can be displaying the videos in a number of ways. So if you click on start here, you select how the videos are displayed. So we have a large icon view. There's a medium icon view, small icon view, and then there's a detail view. And if we are in the detail view, you select which column display information about the videos. And you can change the order and the size of these columns. So the ID is like a unique ID for each video. It's always going to be unique. Then we have the length, and then we have the preview window. And as I said, you can change the size of the columns. So just drag here. And you can change the orders of the columns. And this order and size of the columns are set with your layout. So then what is the layout? If you go to the layout menu, you see that there is 8 buttons here. Each one is connected to a shortcut. So you have 8 possible layouts. So you can quickly change between these layouts and you can edit them. So once you moved your windows and configure them as you want, then you just click save, and then that setup is saved with your layout. So how do you then move the videos? Yeah, of course you can just drag the sizes to change the size. You can hold down the mouse button on a window like this and just drag it, and then you tear that window away. You can change the size and you can dock it somewhere else if you want to, like this. So you can configure your layout like that. You have a bunch of tabs here. So let's take our add video tab, click the left mouse button, drag it out, and then you have another window. So you move that here, and then you have our add video and we have a playlist. Let's switch that to catalog. We see that at the same time. If I click a video, I see the thumbnails from that video. And if I click on one of the thumbnails, it's gonna play in the video player down here. I can of course move it around the video player where I want it. So I can configure it like this. It's gonna play there. And you see it's actually not playing. Why is that? Well, it's paused. So if I just click, it's gonna play again. Pause, play. And as I said, you quickly switch between this. So layouts, super important to get the most out of the program. It may seem a bit confusing that there's different windows, but you can basically set up different layouts for different work tasks. So you have one layout for adding videos where you just have the add video windows. You have one layout for working with files, perhaps. You have one layout for working with the playlist, one for searching videos, and so on. So you basically, by setting up only the windows you need for your specific work, you get more space, of course, and hopefully you see more. Like here, you have a list from top to bottom, instead of if the program would lay out like this, you would have less space. So use the layouts here. So the next menu I want to talk about is the view menu. So here you basically have all the functionality, all the windows. So each button here is enabling, disabling one group of functionality that are displayed in one windows. So let's just quickly go through them. So we have the search window, searching for videos, filtering them. We'll talk more about that in detail in a video in the future. Add video, adding videos, we talked about that. video catalog. This window shows all the videos, but it's also a bit special because it determines the currently selected video. So now this is selected, change that, change the selected video, and that selection is gonna affect other windows. So that's why it's a bit special. Bins allow you to collect videos in bins or like kind of virtual folders inside of the catalog without actually moving the video file anywhere on any disk. So that's also a pretty important point, that whatever you change in Fast Video Cataloger, you don't move the video files. They are where they are, which is a good thing, I would say. Next one is the video wall. So the video wall, it shows basically animations of the thumbnails you have. So actor shows actors you have in your catalog. File organizer is like an integrated file explorer. This allows you to move videos around if you want to change the folder they're stored or move them between drives. And as you do so, the catalog is updated at the same time. So this is one of the ways to make sure your catalog is in sync with your video files. Preview image is for when you have companion images. We're gonna talk more about that later, but you can, each video can have a bunch of companion images. Playlists are a functionality to create like segments from videos and combining those segments. So playlists can then be exported into video editing programs and so on. So basically a virtual video with cuts from different videos. Then you have these three windows. These are attract windows. So the name attract is basic from the old arcade games, where when you weren't playing the games, they showed you like samples of the game just to get you attracted to the console. So this basically just shows random selection from your whole catalog to give you inspiration. So attract video wall shows animated random videos from your catalog. Attract actors does the same with actors, and attract covers does the same with companion images. So let's move on to that next group of videos. So web is the integrated web browser we have. By default, just show a help test page on our website, but it's really a full embedded Chromium web browser. You can use it to download videos straight into the catalog, and you can use it in script to do custom solutions. Next is video scenes. So this is basically the window that shows the thumbnail from the selected videos. And then scene search result is the window that shows results from tagged scenes that you have searched for. Next group here are the video player. We already saw that. We have the companion and cover images, shows companion images. We have the companion image browser, also shows companion images, but in another way. We have just showing covers for videos. And then we have the script console, where you can create C# scripts to automate tasks in Fast Video Cataloger, or extend Fast Video Cataloger with new functionality, or connect it to other applications. So this is kind of more of an advanced functionality that you might not need to use, but it's there if you want to, once you get like used to the software and want to do more advanced things. The next group of windows are very determined on what the selected video are. So video details shows details about the selected video. So you see these changes. We have the title of the video, some basic information, description you can edit, genre. I would not recommend actually using that. I would prefer keywords because they're way more dynamic and easier to search on. And then we have the extended properties. So those, as I said before, were extracted from the metadata. They ended up in extended properties. We can talk more about that. It's a pretty broad topic and pretty advanced and really useful if you wanna do custom solutions with Fast Video Cataloger or integrate it with other software. So let's go back to the view menu and let's go to the next window, keywording. This is where you add keywords to your videos. We have the integrated documentation. here. We have actions, which is basically a way, also a way to customize the software to create like buttons to launch automations that you have created yourself. Also, a video in the future, gonna go into more details about that. Cast is basically the actors that are set to a video. And then finally, we have this ability to zoom the thumbnails. And then you can also save layout here. So with the current setup of Windows. So I think that gives a good overview of the basic functionality we have in Fast Video Cataloger. So important window is a video catalog window. This is where you see your videos, layouts, use them, allow you to set up a different dashboard with the windows you need for the work you're doing. And then view, here you can toggle the windows on and off. If you somehow like mess up your layout or your windows disappear, you didn't know where they landed, you can always reset it to the default layout and get back where you started. So I think that's it for today. Stay tuned for the next video.